Starting a new chapter today for housekeeping, and it will be your wall covering chapters. It's a new chapter and followed by your second topic from your syllabus of your second semester, and it is one of the major one, you can say. We'll be studying what is wall covering, what are the types of wall coverings, and why we should use the wall covering. So, what is wall covering? It's a basically decorative attachment or decorative features that we provide in our hotel rooms, and that brings different kind of color patterns, texture, light and shade, which are available in greatest form and decorative form that we need to provide to our hotel guest rooms to give our decorative effects. Okay, on the other hand, this covering may be required a particular easy clean hygienic surface consistency. Why so? For example, I am using a particular wall covering which is kind of a sticker, like paper made or any kind of color base, and if I am not using this kind of wall covering features on a particular consistency of a wall which is having some kind of damp coating, that particular finish or glossiness will not going to arrive. To maintain that one, we have some category that we need to maintain before establishing any kind of wall coverings on the wall. So which are those? Number one, it will be the contribution to the decor. What is contribution to the decor? See, it's a kind of a color, texture, pattern, as I told you. For example, a light category or the light base of wall will going to support a color consistency with multicolor or dark color or semi-dark color as well, but never the light color, because the variation or the background for this light color consistency for your wall will never going to give you some good look or nice color reflection or tone on your wall side. Next, what it will be? Easy to clean. Yeah, obviously, once you are using a decorative features on your wall, you are cleaning should be done on frequent manner, because the dust or dirt will going to be there or absorb on the wall. So you should fix a kind of wall covering on the wall that you can clean so easily, rather or in comparative with not by scrubbing or scratching or anything, otherwise it will going to deteriorate, right? Third one, it will be state of your existing surface. For example, you are fixing some kind of wall covering which is made with of tech nowadays we are using, which is kind of texture painting, right? Now your base wall is made of concrete, obviously, and that regular base is not smooth or shine enough to fix that secondary attachment that you are using as your wall covering. What will happen? It will not going to stuck properly, and after few years or after 6 months, it will going to deteriorate. So that standard you need to maintain. For that reason, what you need to check for? You need to check for the base category of the wall, right? Then what is number four? Number four, it will be your the resistant to the abrasion and the knocks. Abrasion and knocks is quite hectic pronunciation kind of a thing. See, it's a hard surface that will be the best. For example, I'm telling you, this thermocol, if you are using that thermocol as a base and you are using kind of a color coating or the wax coating on that particular top surface of that thermocol base, it will not going to stuck forever. Why? That particular consistency or that molecules of the thermocol is not too much hard. It's not about the hardness, but it depends on the wall covering that you are using on a particular surface. Similarly, the oil coating or the wall oil color that we need to paint on the wall, if that consistency is made with a glass or rather that consistency is made with of any kind of concrete, or rather that consistency or that wall is made with of some kind of wood kind of texture, you cannot use that oil coating every time, because that will not going to stuck permanently on the wall surface. That particular thing you need to maintain, which is known as resistance to the abrasion and the knocks, right? And number five, it will be stain resistance. Yeah, stain resistance. Nowadays we are facing a regular problem which is known as some kind of rust. You know, jung bolte hai na, lag jata hai kapdo pe. You are keeping some kind of linen or dress cloth or any other material and hanging by a particular attachment like a hooks or hanger with a wall. We found some kind of spot at the time of monsoon. Hota hai na, saban ke time mein kuch, you know, dark spot lag jata hai. You know, because of that oxidation it happens. Now let's go for this chapter that we are discussing with this wall covering. Yeah, for choosing for that wall covering and before, you know, fixing it nicely, we need to check for that porous surface which is supposed to be the more resistance, you know, or equivalent to the regular surfaces. Okay, number last but not the least, it's durability. What is durability? Boss, if we are using any kind of wall covering, jo pehla wala thing jo hum logo ke dimag mein aata hai, boss, whatever the material that I am fixing, it should last for, you know, many years so that my initial cost should give me some kind of outcome. It's not like I am fixing that particular wall covering and it's going to be deteriorate after a couple of years. It's not your proper outcome, right? So you should fix a particular wall covering that not only gives you a nice ethnic standard look as per the standard of your hotel, but also it should give you some kind of durability, sustainability, stain resistance, state of existing surface, easy to clean, and many more as I discuss you just before the same. Okay, so now the types of wall covering. See, it will not be too much of possible for me to complete the things all in this single slide. Okay, so I'm telling you in short, the basic things you should study for this particular chapter will be types of wall coverings that will be comes under the paints and lacquers, the emulsion paint. Emulsion paint is very much easy chapter. It's a particular, you know, small portion rather. What is emulsion paint? You need to fix up kind of a some base coloring, and that we need to fix with some multiple color contrast. आप लोग जब कलर के दुकान में जाते हो, नाउ इट इज वी आर हैविंग मेनी ऑफ द कलर मैन्युफैक्चरर्स लाइक यू हैव हर्ड ऑफ दिस एशियन पेंट्स देन डिलक्स एंड मेनी मोर. व्हाट दे डज, दे आर हैविंग सम काइंड ऑफ बेस कलर बेस, विद इन दैट दे मिक्स सम मल्टीपल कलर डिपेंडिंग ऑन द कंट्रास्ट, डिपेंडिंग ऑन द यू नो बेस सिनेरियो ऑफ योर वॉल कवरिंग, एंड दे प्रिपेयर द पर्टिकुलर इमल्शन as kind of a compound. So they fix it, all these variation that details you will find in this note. Later you will find some kind of texture and some diagrams are mentioned over here, which is known as advantages and disadvantages of the wall covering. See, I'm telling you in short, these wall coverings are very good if you are using in a proper way, if you are maintaining the things in a step by step way or affirmative way, it will give you a certain very much good look. But what problem arises, you know, if the hotel establishment thought no, after 5 years this kind of decoration become a backdated or I need to modify my standard, they need to repaint the area. So that portion should be keep it in mind of the hotel authority as well as the, you know, the decorators. For that particular reason, this chapter is very much necessary. Please study hard about this particular chapter and you will definitely get some few questions which will be very much important for your you know, scoring marks in the examination. Please give your best shots, and if you find any kind of difficulties, please let me know by WhatsApp or by mail. Thank you.